Earlier this month, we launched a new segment on Studio 10 saluting ordinary and extraordinary Australians. It's brought to you by Included Charity. And we're asking, what sort of legacy do you want to leave? Legacy to have and to leave than a world where human rights are enjoyed by all. Please welcome Claire Mallinson from Amnesty International Australia. Welcome to the show, Claire. Amnesty is a global movement that's operating in more than 150 countries. It's a big job. What's the mission statement?
Well, fundamentally, we're about protecting and saving people's lives. Our vision is a world where people can live free from torture, free from discrimination, free from persecution. And we want everybody to have a fair go, to have justice and dignity and equal opportunities.
It is a terrific organisation. We've done some work together before, of course. Now, it's been around since the 60s. Is it making the world a better place? Because it sometimes feels like, you know, evil persists and it's just getting worse and worse.
Well, you know, we all have good days and bad days, particularly in terms of human rights. But there has been some significant progress. We've got a global arms trade treaty. There's been huge progress in women's rights, though there's a lot still to do. Mm. I mean, recently we've been working on women's rights in Afghanistan. And we worked on a case on a young girl called Brishna, a 10-year-old girl who was raped. Now, 10 years ago, she would have then been stoned. Mm. Thankfully, because of the work that Amnesty and Amnesty's supporters did right around the world, we've got legislation in place to ensure that she was protected and to ensure that that rapist was brought to account and now jailed. So, huge progress there. Mm-hmm. Also in Morocco, extraordinary legislation was in place there where if a young girl was raped, they would be forced to marry their rapist.
Gosh.
Because of the work that Amnesty's done, that legislation has been changed. Yeah, so, some huge progress in terms of women's rights, but still a long way to go. Yeah. As we know here in Australia, women don't get equal opportunities.
Yeah. Now, one of your principles is that no government is beyond scrutiny and no situation is beyond hope. I bet it doesn't always feel like that.
Well, I'm a great optimist and you know, you've got to be
if you
work for Amnesty International. And, you know, if I think about our work on the death penalty, when we started, only 16 countries had a moratorium on the death penalty. Now over 140 countries have ended the death penalty. So huge progress. And one of the highlights for me last year was a man we've been campaigning for, a Hakamada in Japan. He had been on death row for 45 years. Mm-hmm. And we got him released because they finally admitted they got it wrong. And I spoke to his sister, who actually said to me it was her greatest moment when she was able to tuck him up in bed at night when he came home and gave him a cup of tea in the morning.
How lovely.
Wow. Now, Amnesty International is working on numerous campaigns. And what is your main focus at the moment?
Well, one of our big priorities is crisis situation in Syria and the millions of refugees who have been affected. I mean, it is probably the greatest challenge of our generation. There are millions of people who've had to flee Syria. I mean, there's 4 million have had to leave their home and 7 million are internally displaced there. And Australia can do more. I mean,
it concerns me about Syria, knowing the casualties of the war and the fact that America has now asked Australia to join in bombing. And I thought, gosh, that means more innocent people are going to be killed and become casualties.
I mean, it is a real risk because, you know, and it is often women and children, very innocent civilians that get caught up. And hundreds of thousands of Syrian women and children have been killed now. And so if countries like America, and I know Australia's thinking about going in as well, if they are going in, they have to be really careful that they follow international human rights law and that they protect civilians. And Amnesty's researchers have been into Syria, and there's examples where, you know, under friendly fire, innocent civilians have been caught up.
The rationale for bombing Islamic State strongholds is to stop the flow of refugees and to liberate the country from ISIS. So it's the opposite of that.
It's a hard call, though, isn't it?
It's a very hard call, and protection of civilians has to be absolutely at the forefront of any government policy. But there are practical things that Australia can do in the meantime. Australia can actually take more refugees. I mean, there are millions of freed, and Australia's said, oh, well, we'll take maybe 1,600 over the next 3 years every year. Well, that's a drop in the ocean. We must do more. We can increase our humanitarian aid. We can put pressure on the UN Security Council to actually refer the president of Syria to the International Criminal Court. So there's lots of really practical things that the Australian government can do now.
Claire, thank you so much for coming in and speaking about the wonderful work that Amnesty International does right around the world. And if you want to leave a legacy to groups like Amnesty, head to includedcharity.com.au. There are more than 140 charities to choose from. And their ultimate goal is to encourage all of us to think about leaving a gift in our will. Include a Charity Week runs from September 7th to the 13th, so get on board.